From Seamus's old crooked cousin by marriage, we should hang up our hats now.
That must be the place up ahead. We should go on foot from here. Let's see what we're dealing with. Come on. There's the house. I see the barn in the back. Stagecoach has to be in there. Okay, let's take a quick look at the place. You've got binoculars. Will you get your binoculars out so we can scan this place together? We don't want any surprises.
Anyone around?
Yes. Okay. I reckon we can do it now. I'll head over, distract him by putting on a little show while you sneak into the house, find what you can, then get the stagecoach. Or wait until nightfall. Sneak in, then I'll get the coach. You can try the house. What do you think?
Let's wait.
Okay, let's go.
Sure.
You go into the house. I'll go find this wagon.
Maybe take a peek through the windows before you go in. Make sure it's all quiet. Get on, dear boy. Come on, get on and let's head back. Problems the better right now. Just need to get this back to Seamus in one piece, and it's a good night's work. So what were you able to lift from the house?
A few bits and pieces. Nothing too fancy.
Well, we need anything we can get right now.
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly anyway.
No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye. And as usual, he did not flinch.
Exactly. How long do you think we're gonna stick around here for?
Not sure. Till we can't, I suppose. Feels like we're starting to get back on our feet, slowly but surely. Just need to keep at it. Dutch has a new money chest stashed in a safe spot away from camp, but it's a long way from being full.
I hope it's not stashed in town like we did in Blackwater. Even if we had to dump the money from the ferry, we could have at least got the rest out if it was hidden someplace else.
No, I think we've learned our lesson, Mayor. And a few other lessons besides. Okay, here we are. Just pull the coach into the barn there.
So up now.
Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly. Nice work, Hosea.
It was mostly Arthur. Like I said, coarse, but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for them. But discreet, you know.
Of course.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
Sure. Hey, I think my back needs some working over.
Well, lie down and I'll get cracking.
I don't think so. Okay.
Hello, Arthur. Everything ends. Nobody wants whale oil no more. Everybody's running out west for gold and land and oil and freedom.
Well,
so I spend a couple of years, but it's not what I imagined. Without the hunt, it's not really anything. I don't want to simply carry things across the sea. I want to pull things from it. So I too go west. And soon I fall into some terrible trouble with some really bad men I meet. They force me to marry a woman so they can steal all my money. But
that's what I like to hear.
Then Dutch finds me. Very much at
every time, Uncle.
And you boys know the rest of that story. Now, I'm a ship cook. For a camp with no ship.
Mr. Morgan, bring me some materials, and I'll be glad to make something nice for you.
Okay,
I think that's enough for me.
keep my eye out for some good material. Hey there.
Hey, Arthur.
How are you?
Trying to put on a good face.
Well, don't moan about it.
How you gentlemen keeping? Sorry for interrupting, but I can't stand much longer over there. I mean, I love the girls, but my lord, they complain a lot. I mean, I've known worse than this. I was born into worse than this. Most of us grew up hungry and scared and alone, one way or another. And here, we've usually got food and we usually ain't scared. I mean, sometimes. And we ain't never alone. Not here. Quite the opposite. So I'm done with the whining.
Mr. Morgan, you saved my life, and I'm very grateful.
Don't mention it, Reverend.
I made a fool of myself.
We've all done it.
I get so confused and angry, and then I hear God laughing at me, and I get even angrier, and, well, I'm a real...
I'm sorry. Can this wait till later?
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. okay then.
Rediscovery of theology.
Gentlemen!
Shall of safety.
Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. The path to truth.
Well, I mean, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I'm still searching, I guess.
We are all searching. Chelonianism is about searching. What do we search for, do you think?
You're searching for whoever stole your common sense, you nutcase!
Are you always this negative and antagonistic, sir?
Only when dealing with idiots. Now let me talk to the boy! I'm starting to lose my patience with you. Goddamn lunatic!
Stop it, Arthur! That's enough, Arthur!
Kid, come on. This is crap. You're better than this.
Better than what? Better than one in paradise?
Better than thinking these fools know a damn thing about paradise. Now let me take you home.
You're a sad man, Arthur. You're a real sad man.
Sure, but come home.
No, not a chance!
Sister's worried about you.
This is none of your damn business. Sorry.
They're just using you. Telling you what you want to hear.
What the hell do you know about it, Arthur?
Yeah. For Christ's sakes, Jamie, just hold up a minute.
You pop up out of nowhere?
Let's talk about this!
I don't have to answer to you!
Damn it, we gotta do this the hard way! Come on, you ain't stupid! You can see this is crazy!
You're the crazy one!
Yep.
Morgan, leave me alone.
Please, kid. Put that gun down.
I warn you, Arthur. I don't want to live anymore.
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone. I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone! I warn you, Arthur! I don't want to live anymore!
Kid, just calm down.
Leave me alone!